Okay, so let's continue. Now that we had fetch information from the database, we should check whether information exists. That means whether some information has been gathered. So if ID with such a record exists, whether if an ID exists, then actually if ID doesn't exist, then we should insert into this database. Values. Okay, so now we need to check the values which we would like to insert, and I didn't create another value which is page and watcher of 500. Save page. Okay, so first is page, and then is who. It's a different language, pages, and who is the same as here. So once this is inserted, we need to fetch the same record again to show in these fields. So once information is fetched, we could also show it in the form because of the information. So let's start with name, because we fetch all from this database, and let's start by name. So I didn't wrote a name, so let's use value 2 as name. Sorry. And use this unicode, and then if name. We don't have surname in database, so let's create another field with surname. Let's use it directly under name. After name. Surname also 300, and use this Unicode because there could be Russians and people from China and so on. Phone was phone underline NR. Email was just email. Country was country. Sorry, wrong button. City. But let's check in our database whether such information exists. Country, city, address 1DSS, phone number. Postal code. Okay, we don't have postal code, let's use directly under address. Just to keep it planned. Postal, just write postal. Minor 50. Postal. PayPal email was PayPal email. Okay, so now that we have it already inserted, we should write update function. Note that update must be done directly before the information is fetched. So if you put it under, the information is fetched, and then you update information, and then it shows the old information. So we need first update, and then we can fetch information. So in this case we write if post, and now we check if the submit button has been pressed, and the name of this is like this, and then we update information, and we just show that information has been saved, like font color equals green, size equals. Actually, I will not show it in this case because I will use a different code there. So now we need to update information, which is MySQL query update, and then console button two times, the database which we like to update, game, user, salary. Keep in mind that you first need to connect to the MySQL server before you can update it, so you should use MySQL connect before any of these MySQL query and fetch functions. Update gallery, user salary, set some value like name equals some other value, and then another time, and we will be updating values where class equals and limit one time. Okay, so don't forget to use perfect grammar. If you leave it like this, I believe it will get an error because you have to leave it empty. But I will be updating many lines, such as wait. Let's start. Name equals MySQL fetch array. Post name. I will just in this tutorial I will just write one of these, oh no, two names, two updates. So it doesn't be too long for you. Okay, and that's about it. Let's save it, upload it. Sorry, I'm just uploading to server, you don't see this, it's got out of the screen. Okay, so refresh. Hope it's too logged in, okay. Like name would be name, surname. Save changes. Okay, so we see that nothing's happening after this button. So we check. Maybe the form doesn't close. Okay, input type is not a button, it's submit. I believe button also works for this, but let's save these changes and then try again. Okay. This means that there is an error between databases in the code. So let's go up. Let's check whether this same error occurs. Okay, it doesn't show any errors because there's a problem with the update function. And let's just check. Didn't see errors. Okay, I'm really sorry, this is wrong. It's MySQL real type. What this means, I automatically write fetch array, but what this means is that slashes in front of, so this code here doesn't break from any of these quotes, because sometimes you write like your name with a a line or a quote. Okay, so we now have it perfectly working. And thanks for watching.